I'm Patty Fernandez, and I'm an art teacher. Visit my website at pattyfernandezartist.com. Okay, let's draw. Today's project is how to draw the sword in the stone. I take one finger on the left and I put a dot and try to make it even across, put another one finger on the right and put another dot. Starting at the left, I'm going to draw a slightly wavy line all the way across to my other dot on the right. I come back to the left. I take one finger on the left and I put a little dot, one finger on the right, put another little dot. Starting on the left dot, I'm going to draw a slightly wavy line up. Come to the right hand side dot. Let's draw another slightly wavy line up. Come back to the left. Let's extend that a little bit. Now let's draw a slightly wavy line over, up, and connect. I come right here in the center, and I'm going to draw a straight diagonal one, straight line two, straight diagonal three, all the way down. Come back to the left, a little bit further out, and we're just going to draw a curved line across and stop. Come back to the left, draw a little curved line up on the left, little curved line up on the right. Come back to the left, draw a curved line across, and connect. Right about here on the center, we're going to go one, two, three curved lines going up, straight line across, one, two, three curved lines going down. If you have room, you can put another curved line right here at the top. Come back to the bottom, and we're going to finish these lines. Curve line up, connect on the left, curve line up, connect on the right. Now I want this to look like it's got magical powers, King Arthur and Merlin the Magician, so I put little straight lines on the outside of the left, little straight lines on the outside of the right. Come right about here on the left-hand side and just draw a wavy line up. Come right here in the center, wavy line down, and one more little wavy line down on the right. Okay, let's see how we're going to color this in. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do a loop-de-loop baseline in brown at the bottom of my stone. Now you can use brown, you can use gray, you can use a light black. Doesn't matter. Then, using the same color, I came inside the stone and I colored in brown again. And I colored the inside section of this also brown. Then, I have gray. So I used gray for this section. If you have silver or metallic, you can use that, but I have gray, so I use gray. If you don't have gray, you can make it a light, very light black. Then, for this section, I used my yellow, but I double colored it. I put orange over the top because this should be gold. I don't have gold, so I'm using a double color, yellow and orange. If you have gold metallic, you can use that or any of the metallics, really. Then, because this is magic, I wanted my outside part of my sword in the stone to have a straight line of yellow in between each one of these blacks. So it looks like it's shimmering. Okay, let's see what this looks like all colored in. Okay, here's my sword in the stone all colored in. And this is Merlin the Magician and King Arthur. Okay, bye-bye.